Grape jelly.
Strawberry jelly. Either way, it's just jelly.
Thing. Did anybody pick, oh yeah, this is also your, this is your background.
Good evening.
That's for you only too.
Welcome one and all to the part
thing is,
two of mm-hmm. this alien
2 years
adventure.
In the making.
Yep.
Alright.
Has it really been that long?
Yes, it has. So you'll need 6 black dice. No yellow dice yet, just 6 black dice.
Man.
And you don't get stress yet.
I like being diverse.
You don't need stress yet.
Oh yeah, I completely forgot about the stress.
That's what we're saying.
We're taking like 5
minutes.
We're
trying to find the combat knife.
There's the combat knife might not be in there. I think it's just the guns.
Okay, the combat knife probably is just your hidden here.
Yellow. Okay. Oh well, my mom and dad live right here by the church, so it's okay. I mean, I gotta come back and pack up my stuff anyway, so it's cool.
Oh, okay. Yeah, just have a call me when you
guys are almost
done, and I'll tell you where
it is. Okay.
It starts at 5, so I'm assuming you guys will probably be between 5 and 6.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
All right.
Have fun.
Oh, well.
Bye.
So.
Because I know that doesn't have a grenade card, so.
No.
No. I know it does. I've looked in it. Where are you looking for? Is it?
Perfect.
I just started looking.
Right. Can I get a new weapon?
I can't.
Yeah. The weapon cards are going around.
I want a bigger one to add to my collection.
What do you have right now?
It's small stuff. I have the M4 service pistol and the Remix EVA pistol.
Okay.
I got it.
And Eva's with you, right? Yeah. So there's her
M4A3. Should be towards the
back. Yeah, she actually has a stack card.
Go towards the very back as it should
be.
A couple guns before.
Because yeah, we there still got go. Anna and Beth and Anna and Kaylee to do. So I'll leave those right there.
So when it says my rocket launcher, do I just is that
yes.
Okay.
You, so you have rocket launcher.
I also need a grenade launcher, apparently.
We didn't use a camera stand last time.
We had a mic stand last time.
Mic stand.
But the mic stand is...
Chris Derrier did.
It might be in the youth room, it might not, I don't know.
I'm
gonna go. That's usually where I find it. That's usually where I find the mic stand.
Alright, let's see.
So Pilot Davis is not with us. So I will be doing the pilot since everything in PC now. Essentially, science officer.
That is a drop shit
horn.
I don't think.
Your sheet upside down.
I don't think it armors
this
personal carrier.
Yeah, it's just there.
Something I have right.
Really quick. I just threw it up on the table.
I don't think I have a Land Rover either.
But that'll be my weapon.
Man, of all these flamethrowers, it sure does seem like none of us have one.
I have a blowtorch.
I guess that counts.
What?
I'm ignoring him. What?
I need a code.
I'm ignoring you.
Captain Orders.
He does have the Captain Orders skill. I'm sorry.
Very off the ship. I will throw you into dead space. It is not below me. I have done this. I don't like you.
So what's a grenade launcher? A UI grenade launcher. Oh, is that like the shoulder mounted?
No, it's just a regular, you know,
it's
like...
It's part of the smart gun.
No. Like the... Does it have a card? Or...
I don't remember
if it does.
Because this one came with its own set of
weapons.
You gotta
read the things too. It may be a pulse rifle and with the tag or something.
It could be.
There's one more.
Actually, flip.
The grenade launcher should be its own thing.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So the last two are
that's
here.
Kaylee.
Yep, and Glenn just pulled in too. So we
what
are good.
What did you have?
A blowtorch and a bolt gun.
Oh, I just...
At least that's
is
what
it is. Is that what you mean by bolt gun?
I guess.
Yeah, it's a giant gun that fires very high-powered bolts.
I haven't seen
think of a nail gun, but it shoots bolts like heated bolts instead.
Ooh.
It's pretty awesome.
You're the engineer from TF2, essentially.
Yes.
I have not seen a blowtorch, but you could probably prove me wrong.
I kind of wanted to show you what my background is.
If you find grenade launchers, let me know.
Crazy.
Where do I look at my background? I don't think I'm out there.
Let's move in here. As fast as I can. There's only so many going around, unfortunately.
Pelts, banter, weapon specials. M5 RPG launcher. M41A pulse rifle with U1 grenade launcher attached. Okay, so
yeah, it's just the grenade launcher with the on the bottom. It's standard on the rifle.
Carson is sitting somewhere.
Carson's sitting right there. You can just throw
the Bojangles box away.
Yeah, he's still recording. Why is he not recording? Why is he? I wait till the game gets started.
He likes to catch everything. All the funny stuff happens off camera.
That is.
It's a common trend with Carson.
Chris, I think I picked one of my favorite characters.
That's fine.
I don't care if he dies, but good lord, it's really funny.
Alright, so here we go. These are the characters you guys can pick from. There are two in these folders, and then the rest are, you can pick one of these people.
You'll follow orders, but if any of these your wine teammates from the mission, you'll put it down.
Less work. Waiting on them to pick their characters, and then we're good to go.
You know, I had enough of this.
And it was on camera.
I've had enough of this.
And it was on camera.
I'm going to shoot you in the face.
A little bit of a swivel there.
With a bazooka.
You won't be the first. Hey, this side that the camera won't be able to see.
I'm pretty sure Sam took that side.
Yay. Good shot.
Knock the phone over.
Yeah. So everybody wave. Welcome to part two of the Alien D&D.
It is not.
We've got some new folks, some very old folks, and we've got your favorite one, me.
Are we sure you're the favorite?
Yes.
I have two.
Yes. I am the host. I get to be the favorite. My turn.
So they can get their cards?
Oh, weapons.
Yeah.
You mean your weapons?
I'm waiting on you.
Yeah, tell them that. Tell them. Dude. Get them. Right,
there you go. Where's the shotgun?
Over here. This is why we can't have nice things.
Okay. You need to look at what
this
weapons
is why you
have.
Your
oh,
life
son of a frick.
Language.
Oh, darn.
I can't believe.
Are my weapons? I'm assuming weapons are in the fold.
You were a trader.
Yeah, on your character sheet.
How dare you?
I was a lawyer. Okay. This time I'm a psychotic colonial marine.
Wait, do you have a
smart? Right.
No, it's a smart gun. That's even worse.
No, I have a smart gun.
Got it right there in front of me. It should tell you what you have.
Bruh.
If it doesn't, let
basically,
me know.
The heavy of the group.
Alright, I've still got the shotgun.
Okay.
Ooh.
Ooh. Shot,
shot.
So you two got your characters? Alright, who'd you pick?
The automatic rifle guy.
No, like, what's the name?
Kale Iona.
Okay, hold on. Because I got to find, you got what was called a personal agenda. You, What I give you, you cannot reveal to anyone. They're for you only.
Yours.
And who did you say?
I love you. Try to pronounce that.
Zimmerjeski.
I'm going to say this on behalf of myself.
Zimmerjeski.
My tendency when under stress to randomly shoot their gun. So I apologize for any friendly fire.
Just aim for the captain.
Okay, yeah. No,
shoot the captain. It always turns out well.
PTSD.
It always turns out very well.
Pump action shotgun. Is that
for his?
Assuming the safety is on.
Oh, no.
Weapons.
Alright.
You're going to leave that.
So those can go away.
Oh, I can prevent that if I take a fast action to switch the safety.
Just waiting on you guys to get your weapons. Alright, so flip your sheet over. Anna, flip your sheet over. That's your. The other side is your character sheet.
Tells you what stuff you need.
Yep.
Y'all got
you, Jaden.
Y'all gotta speak a little loud. The camera's hard of hearing.
Huh?
Ah!
Do I just get to pick
it? Camera's hard of hearing, like Jake.
Other than what you have, you can hear from
because he's hard of hearing.
Well,
so, you know, he says being around you, Carson, people consider that a perk.
No, not
civilians. Not civilians anymore.
Yeah.
It's like one of those because last game they were technically would be considered civilians comparing to Marine Corps.
Do I look like a civilian to you?
You look like an idiot.
True.
Fair enough.
You guys are now technically hired mercenaries.
Okay, yeah.
So they're technically a military unit contracted by the Colonial Marines to do dirty work.
Alright.
I thought that was supposed to be a 20 Marine
Corps. No, the Colonial Marines don't know as much as they should.
Because
they hire private contractors.
Yes, remember that as the motion tracking.
Keep secrets secret. The company doesn't like their secrets getting out. The Colonial Marines have a bad habit of talking. Quite a bit.
I mean, when you have 2 IQ and you're out in the middle of space.
And love eating crayons.
Yeah. That's true.
You gotta, like.
Is this the Marine Corps now?
No.
Well, the Marines, it's called, has a Marine in it.
I got a question.
Yo.
A friend of mine sent that to the group. Hey,
look at me. Do you have a shotgun?
Yes.
Man,
that was the first kill of the game last time.
I know. Why am I so sorry?
Because you were there.
It was 2 years ago.
Rewatch it. Like, I videoed it for that. So we can study.
That makes me smile this morning.
That is pretty good.
I didn't cut out anything.
I cut the scenes. You know how a lot of the between Irish, transitions.
No, I didn't cut.
We made like, fun of Jinx's robot girlfriend.
No, that's enough.
Jersey.
I love how much it wasn't there.
No, there's a cut that adds that clip, so, and then it cuts back to y'all mine, talking.
They're like,
yeah. You're only going to find the main weapons in there. So you're not going to see the combat knife, stuff like that.
Just
the
armor.
It's just going
to
be your weapon.
Grief. Hey, Chris. Hey Chris, I've got a question.
Pulse rifle. The grenade launcher is part of it.
Being made the
do I still get to use my funny key?
Not for this one.
Nah!
Not for this one. Sorry.
It's too much green on
Can I use it to throw at somebody?
Well, this is the one that says you have. So yeah, you have all.
Oh, there's one with the safety helmet on it.
Find
so.
Me key. Find me key. Find
you
me key.
Get the
find me key.
Alright.
Okay.
She's got the pulse rifle, the grenade launcher, the service pistol, and an incinerator.
Good lord.
Yeah.
I got a smart gun.
Crayons!
I have a knife.
Crayons! Grunts, huh?
I am stuck on napalm because napalm's stuck on me. We binged watched Agent Elvis.
Oh,
it was so good.
I loved it. So it's good, huh?
Oh, right. Amazing.
I have to give it a shot.
And kind of mid.
We're still waiting on weapons and then we're good to go.
I forgot something.
What'd you forget?
I forgot a personal
opinion. Oh, who was yours?
Silva.
Okay.
And hey, you're not, how they're not supposed to show you what they're.
Yeah, there don't
sorry,
show
that's
what
my
they're
bad.
In the
there
cards
you go. So this game, so for you guys that are new, this game happens across 3 acts. So act 1, that's the only agenda card you need to know. You need to try to accomplish your agenda by the end of Act 1.
Now,
if you do, you get what's called a story point.
My appearance.
Story points you can use to do an automatic success roll if you fail. So you guys had 3 from the last game. You can't have any more than 3. So use them. You can maintain 3 if you if your agenda fragged 1, you get a point back, but you can't have any more than 3. So for this act, I suggest you do use them.
Okay.
Because you can always get them back as long as you accomplish your agenda. For each act, you get 1. And we still have our little devotional time like we always do. So, everybody got their weapons?
Is it from a xenomorph?
All right, keep passing.
No. Oh, that's happening. I got a better idea for this thing. Mm-hmm. I'm going to put it next to you since you need to be heard the most.
Dude, really?
Yeah.
What's wrong with where it was?
Because
he's impatient.
You're loud. You're loud.
He's a special.
I got to listen, man. I'm a professional. I do this right.
Carson, does your phone have the memory capacity?
Yes, absolutely. Nice. Absolutely.
Yeah, does it have the memory capacity now?
Absolutely.
Hi.
Man. I love
being
around.
Dude, you can actually put it right here, you know. There's tons of room.
Because
then you can possibly get the entire
island.
Yeah.
Chris,
all they need to do now is
make
the smart gun.
I'll be down with that.
That would spend that $200 on smart gun.
There we go.
Yep, there you go.
Perfect.
There you go.
What I just say.
At least you have something that was smart.
Yeah.
Oh!
What?
Well, we just admitted to not being smart.
Jake, that just means you admitted to not being smart, Mr.
So whether we get through this whole thing or not, I don't know. It's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12.
15 pages.
14 pages.
Dang.
Well, I mean, the other one was just, the other one was just as long. So it just depends on how, just depends on how you guys do it and, you know, everything. Now, the other thing you will need, you can pass these around, pick one. This is your tracker on the map. This should be enough for everybody. There's not letting
step
you know.
Step on, you're probably bleeding.
Yep. It's plus 1 bleeding.
Plus 1 piercing.
No, that's for the
D4.
That's for the
D4. I'm going to forget which blue I am and pick the wrong one.
So you're being yellow?
It doesn't matter.
I'm going to be yellow.
Can I have this?
You cannot have that.
Sure. Sure.
There you
go. Go for it. All right.
Pick your weapons.
Since yours is a returning character, it would make sense.
Yeah, to keep what I had, I mean,
you would,
with nothing new,
you wouldn't survive.
The EVA pistol and the service pistol.
Yeah, then you should be fine to get a rifle.
Right? After what we survived, I think a little something. Do we have pencils?
You're not going to survive. Unless so.
Add to my weapon. It's fine. I don't need it. Hello?
All right,
car. I get it.
You can pick a color, any color. Okay. All right, so I'll let somebody else control the map. I'll tell you where we go. Who?
Dang.
Yep, so you're...
You get white.
You're white.
Dang.
Sorry.
Dang, I'm sorry.
Somebody said no white people on my crew! Oh my god!
This is not...
You are
this
so
is not
mistaken.
Equity. We are not diverse enough.
All right, black. We should
my
be
guy's Asian. My guy looks like a Mongolian.
I'm posted anyway.
Wait, where's Ava?
Ava's
here, and here's
Ava's dead.
There you go.
She is not.
There you go.
Jake, shut up.
She's brutally murdered.
Jake, I'm just letting you know.
Doesn't my guy look like a Mongol?
He looks like a Mongol.
That's what I'm saying.
Anger the captain too much, and she's getting sold for extra the gas money.
Oh,
we don't need him. He's an android. He's an android. We don't need him. We got one.
Is he new?
One is more than enough.
No,
he works
with the same character. Okay.
She's not going to be using new characters.
Yeah, he found her damaged.
So the pilot's still on.
We're going to make her new, Jake.
I think
that's validating your argument.
Since Michael fixed Ava.
So like it gives you a plus two to your roll.
We sold
plus one.
We sold off Michael.
We sold them.
So it's just the stats for the weapon.
The CPU. Yeah, phone with that CPU.
Alright, whenever you're ready, good sir, we are ready.
Alright, ladies and germs.
I love doing bacteria.
Let's go.
Bacteria is awesome.
Except for when it's COVID.
My favorite disease is ringworm.
Shut the one.
Alright.
The one above all, God in the comic books. Many people have noticed that God is hardly ever mentioned in comic books. There are reasons for this. During the late 1940s, many comic books were filled with horror and gratuitous violence. As a result, in the early 1950s, American psychiatrist Frederick Wortham led a crusade against comics, arguing that they incited juvenile delinquency. This was during the height of MacArthurism, 1950-1956. So in 1954, U.S. Senate held televised hearings on comic contribution to youth crime. Although a link wasn't established, the damage of the comic book industry was done, causing a near collapse. The Senate urged publishers to establish strict guidelines so that year the Comic Code Authority, CCA, was created. All comics had to pass the CCA's censors to receive a stamp of approval. Among other things, the code stated that ridicule or attack on any religions group is never permissible, and instructed writers to respect all beliefs in religious institutions. Publishers usually played it safe by avoiding the subject altogether. Another factor was that until 1962, American public schools began their days with a short Bible reading and by reciting the Lord's Prayer. Then in 1962-63, the Supreme Court banned public prayer and Bible reading from schools. Producers of comics, still smarting from the anti-comic book hysteria of the 50s, took their cue and usually didn't even give passing mention to a superhero's faith or the existence of God. Not that many of them had been inclined to promote overt Christian messages prior to this. They did delve into ancient Egyptian, Greek, and Norse gods because those religions had long been retired to the realms of mythology. There had already been a number of superheroes based on Greek and Roman gods, so the Norse god Thor, which first appeared in 1962, was readily accepted. Writers also felt free to discuss the occult, hence the 1963 debut of the magician Doctor Strange was well received. However, living faiths such as Judaism and Christianity were usually passed over in silence. Anytime being identifiable as the Judeo-Christian god was mentioned in the pages of comic book, you can be sure that it didn't happen without a great deal of thought. The writers had to really want to include it. As would be expected, the mentions were few and far between, but when assembled, they present a clear picture of the true God. This is especially true for Marvel Comics. DC Comics, while they depicted a being named the Presence, have few unambiguous mentions. In a 1968 issue of Fantastic Four, when her husband Reed Richards was in grave danger, Sue asks, "But what can he do against the all-powerful Silver Surfer?" A watcher, an ancient wise being named Utu, responds, "All-powerful, there is only one who deserves that name, and his only weapon is love." This is the best possible description of God, since the Apostle John tells us God is love, 1 John 4:8. In April 1976, Marvel gave God a title when introduced an omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent being called the One Above All. He was more powerful and exalted than any entity or god in the entire Marvel Universe. Even the Norse god of thunder, Thor, was in awe of him, calling him the creator of all universes. The One Above All was responsible for the existence of all matter, energy, and life throughout every dimension. At one point, a superhero named Adam Warlock told how he had been summoned to be judged by an entity called the Living Tribunal, who, great as he was the servant of the one who is above even gods. Yes, in the Marvel Universe, the one true God is above all the Watchers, the Elders of the Universe, the Celestials, the Elder Gods, the Gods of Asgard, the Vishanti, the Cosmic Entities, and even the Living Tribunal.
Now the cosmic entities are eternal beings who wield power on an unimaginably vast scale, who are an integral part of the space-time continuum, essential to the running of the physical universe. The greatest cosmic entity is an omnipresent being named Eternity, but during one encounter, Eternity tells Doctor Strange that he and his fellow entity Death compromised all the reality Doctor Strange knows, but adds, neither he nor I are God, for God rules all realities. Around the turn of the 21st century, when the cosmic code became obsolete and the hesitation about mentioning Christianity relaxed, comic book writers began drawing from its rich literature, lore, and symbols. This didn't mean the writers were Christians, though some were, but knowledge of Christianity still permeated Western society, and people were familiar with its concepts. Thus, superheroes slowly began to be depicted praying to God, attending church, and fighting demons. In the final analysis, we shouldn't criticize the comic book industry too harshly for refraining from promoting belief in God. It's not their job to preach the gospel. Jesus gave that task to us, his followers, and even many of us shy away from it. But it's great when comics at least give the one true God some loving overdue recognition. Nice. Let's do this.
Wait, no, Captain's orders. I want to hear another story. Oh my gosh.
Can you read me a bedtime story?
Once upon a time, there was a crew that I got eaten by aliens. The end.
Whoa, I love this.
I
love it. Where did the crayon come in?
Can you hit the Gwitty?
Can you hit the Gwitty, please?
It's an Arctic wasteland.
Aliens aren't worse than the last time.
It's just an Among Us app.
They're bigger.
Two weeks later.
Just
okay.
Game over.
Damn.
Oh my god. I didn't know we already lost.
Bro, this is like early 2000s PlayStation.
Hey, I use what I got.
Yeah, I'm not saying nothing wrong about that. That's like cool.
Is that our?
It's like seeing
Yeah, that's our baby.
Yeah, it's right there.
It's like playing army, like the army men, the green soldiers.
Yeah, wonder for cross landing. Everybody, buckle up.
You had one job: land the ship. That's it.
The pilot was asleep at the wheel.
Man, there's so much go off my shoulders.
How do you want this thing going? Made it.
Beautiful vessel.
Jake, would you
scream
your
card
for the
business card? Where did you find that? I made it. Yeah, I made it. Most of it.
Grammy Award right there.
That's actually a Grammy Award.
Alright. So.
Save that for your robot wife, Jake.
So this would be the part where you guys now gear up.
Keep my wife out of
trouble. Keep my wife out of trouble.
All right. Now that we finally landed, Cap needs a shotgun. Someone go help me find him. Everybody get your gear. Let's get to this thing. It's been a long freaking flight. Now I don't want to talk about what happened last time.
It was like three years ago.
I'd like to drink those memories away.
Don't we all?
I've been trying to drink those memories away.
I just wrapped it for a half.
Oh, what's the difference between the red and white?
Nothing. Just one's round corners.
Yeah.
It's all the time to compare head.
Oh. I like the sharper head.
I have 3 and 3, so as we're
hopping off the ship.
Something strange.
This is America.
I had it.
Okay,
so now. All right, so you guys
America.
Do
There's
your
guns everywhere.
Thing.
What are we doing?
You're getting your gear together. You're talking. Introduce yourselves. You have a bunch of new players.
The citizens, not the army.
So yeah, this is gaming introductions.
My name is Andrews. Last time I was out and about, things went south pretty quick. I remember that dude. The alien popped out of him. And he got shot by a shotgun. Everywhere. Acid spewed everywhere. Oh, God.
I am so glad that didn't spray on me, because I was
right?
Point blank. First kill, though. Freck you.
This is my android lady friend, Ava.
I'm assuming the white stuff is still blood that you just refused to clean up.
It's been 3 years, man. She's like a brand new android.
Then why is there still white stuff on it?
Shut up. Alright. That's my introduction. Move on.
Alright, who's next?
Oh, I'm the medic, by the way. I didn't mention that.
Yeah, that's a good ability.
See, the funny thing is, you're the most decked out of all of us right now, but you're the medic. Interesting.
I learned a thing or two because I've seen
a thing or two.
That's fair. We did almost die. Bum, 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 bum.
That's great. All right, who's next?
I'll go, I guess. My name is Roof and Dante. I am the breacher here. So if you need something to explode, I'm your guy.
Cool.
I like you.
I like blowing stuff up. I like you too.
Yeah!
Wow. The first time people like me. That's up there.
Hey, you guys remember that weird pilot guy last time? He was kind of lame.
I know, right? People saved him even knowing he wanted to die.
Yeah, it was sad.
There's a reason why I'm bringing it. It's
like our ship being toxic.
That's good. Yeah,
the only actor.
Who are you?
He's a pilot and you didn't have a ship.
Oh, me? Hammer.
Are you hammer? Are hammer yes. Or hammered?
Yes.
Hammer.
He's done both.
You hammered it. Hammer.
It's hammer. You private need, hammer before I snap. Before I knock your teeth out, man.
You need to lay off the sauce. Doctor's orders.
Really nailed that one, didn't you?
City.
I did a line of coke before I came here.
And you, Missy? What do you do? What do you bring to this ragtag group of partiers?
She is a CBNRN.
It's a lot of words.
That's chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear what? Defense specialist.
That's a lot of words.
Defense specialist?
What, a nuclear scientist?
Like, all I am is the rifleman.
That's so much better than a lawyer.
Yeah. Really get to blow up the planet?
Problem.
New objective.
New objective.
Captain's orders.
All other objectives are superseded by nothing except for blowing up the planet.
As long as I live.
That is fine by me.
We're going to call this a total loss, and we're out. Bye.
We haven't even gone down yet.
All right.
Who are you?
All right, who's next?
I'll wait for last since I'm Captain.
I'm Ronnie. I'm your technician.
Are you the same? How you tag?
Are you the wait?
I want to call you Goggles.
He's the yeah.
Goggles.
He's the reference.
Bruh.
Hey, I've got a question.
I think he got the reference.
You're the same guy as last time.
Right? He looks like Dustin.
Did you get the reference?
I feel like I do. His goggles sound like
Goggles.
Yeah. Remember
that when you secretly
turned out to be an Android? Yeah.
Pretty
simple.
Hey, you want the green one?
Heck.
No.
I'm just saying, be careful.
Well, Kale does turn brown eventually.
I was just warning our roughneck, who, if you remember, is an android that you seem to have a thing for. So I was just making sure he knows to stay away.
I think they already had that problem.
It's okay, the engineer's not here.
No, he's a
technician, but there's also the engineer.
Yeah. Alright, who's next?
Alright, moving on.
Beatrice Silva.
Are you?
I don't know what it says.
Are you a Colonial Marine?
Right here. She's field commander.
A field commander? Okay.
Okay. Nice.
So you're a Marine commander. Nice.
She says, bend over, you say, how far?
Amazing. How far, drill sergeant? All
right, Kale.
Kale. Who are you, Kale?
I'm an automatic rifleman.
Nice.
Whoa. Nice.
I have a gun and a knife.
They have a gun and a knife.
I have a rocket launcher.
Dang.
All I got is a rocket launcher.
That's kind of sus. I'm not going to lie.
All I got is a rocket
launcher. It's literally Sergeant Johnson. Oh, yeah. With rocks on the sticks.
Now you're Kale.
For one platoon!
Right.
And we got
a
chair!
Alright, Kaylee.
That's scary.
Smijewski. Stanley Smijewski. I'm not a people person, but I am a rifleman, so don't get in my way or I'll have to show you the belt.
The belt?
She did the smart thing and read the character's personal.
Did your father hurt you?
The background.
I'm psychotic.
Yes.
And we don't talk about Bruno.
Save the best for last, as you should.
We don't talk
Hello,
about Bruno.
Everybody. It is your humble and thrifty captain,
Vanessa
Miller.
I
didn't ask for your interruption, Sergeant. Now please be quiet.
I'm not a sergeant.
Well, you know what? I'm the captain. You get to be a sergeant now.
You want me to take care of that cattle? I can take care of that for you.
Save it for later. We might need the ammo
on him.
But keep an extra round.
Chris.
Tired of being a corporate cog, I decided I'd go ahead and get myself my own ship, and now I'm running with my thrifty crew here, ready to
explore the galaxy.
I don't remember how to roll
the dice. To boldly go. No alien has gone before.
Yep.
Nice.
Space?
The Final Frontier.
These are the voyages of the ragtag group of, what's their name, membership?
So tell you.
Red shirts.
That one. No, you're wearing a red shirt, which means...